Hello, my dear students. Continuing the same chapter, chapter number 8, Africa in Geography, I am continuing the different topics which are left in this chapter. So, let's start. Physical features of Africa, heading number 5, the coastal lowlands and islands of Africa. Africa is a plateau continent, coastal or coastal belts of Africa is low and narrow. Coastal lowlands are mainly found along the Mediterranean Sea and the Atlantic Ocean, which are comparatively wider narrow river basin. Basins are found in the Zaire Basin. Next is the drainage system of Africa. The rivers of Africa have special features as compared to the rivers of the other continents. Most of them flow over the plateau in their upper course and they are navigable, but they drop down to their lower courses as they reach the coastal plain in the form of waterfalls and rapids. So let's start to know about the drainage system of Africa. To the main African rivers belong Nile, longest river of Africa, Congo, and the Niger, which flows half of its length through the arid areas. The largest lakes are the following: Lake Victoria, Lake Chad in the center of the continent, Lake Tanganyika lying between the Democratic Republic of Congo, Burundi, Tanzania and Zambia. There is also the considerably large Lake Malawi stretching along the eastern border of one of the poorest countries in the world, Malawi. There are also numerous water dams throughout the continent. Kariba on the river of Zambezi, Aswan in Egypt, on the river of Nile, and the biggest dam of the continent lie completely in the Republic of Ghana is called Ekosombo on the Volta River. The high lake plateau of the African Great Lakes region contains the headwaters of both the Nile and the Congo. So next, I'm going to start cocoa cultivation in Ghana. Cocoa, an important commercial crop of the equatorial region, is extensively planted in areas bordering the Gulf of Guinea in West Africa, which include the countries of Ghana, Nigeria, Ivory Coast, Liberia, Sierra Leone, Togo and Dahomey. In Ghana, the cocoa or chocolate trees was introduced about 90 years ago. Today, Ghana is an important producer of cocoa in the world. It accounts for about 11% of the world's total. The cocoa plantation of Ghana are vast. Ghana is located in Western Africa along the Gulf of Guinea. Climatic condition and soil. Climate: cocoa can be grown up to 300 meter above mean sea level. It requires a minimum of 90 to 100 millimeter rainfall per month, with an annual rainfall of 1500 or 2000. The plant need equitable climate with well distributed rainfall. Hot and wet climate is suitable for the production of cocoa. Temperature: cocoa need 27 degrees centigrade. And soil, if we talk about soil, cocoa plants need well drained porous soil and a shelter from strong winds and direct light. Methods of planting cocoa trees. The plant is grown as a mixed crop with other plants like species and rubber, mainly under rain-fed conditions. Cocoa is planted as an intercrop in coconut and arcanut gardens. One cocoa row of plants at 2.7 meter interval at the center of two arecanut rows. Likewise, alternate gaps of arecanut rows should be filled in. Methods of cocoa harvesting. Harvesting time season is from September to January. Generally, harvesting of cocoa pods begins in the morning. The required pods are picked carefully by hand pickers. They are called tumbadas. Fermentation. Following steps are taken for the proper fermentation of cocoa. Firstly, the beans covered with pulp are heaped on ground and covered with large banana leaves. Second, before fermentation, the beans must not be washed. Next, fermentation brings about changes inside the beans which leads to chocolate flavor. Next, the high temperature does not allow the beans to germinate. It gives the bean the chocolate flavor and brown color. Next, it takes 3 to 8 days for the beans to ferment. Next, after fermentation, the cocoa beans are thoroughly dried in the sun. Processing of cocoa beans. Following steps are taken. First is in the factory, the beans are roasted to dark brown as required. Second, during the time of roasting, they give a rich aroma. Next, the roasted beans are then cracked and the shells is removed. Next, then the beans are crushed in the grinding stones in the grinding mill. What are the uses of cocoa beans and cocoa butter? Cocoa butter is mixed with chocolate liqueur to form the basic ingredients for chocolates. Sugar and other flavoring substances are added to chocolate liqueur before baking. Chocolate is also used for many other products like ice creams, cakes, pastries, biscuits, etc. Chocolate powder is used for making cakes and sauces. Some cocoa products are shown in this image. Image of processing of cocoa beans. And these are cocoa trees.